Hey everyone, I'm Joey with Joey's Balloon Company. In this video, I'm gonna be teaching you how to make a two-balloon Spider-Man. You're gonna need a few things in order to create this: a dual-action hand inflator, two 260 balloons in red and blue. You can get both of these items using the link in the description below. You'll need a Sharpie for drawing on the face and the character design, and also you're going to need to like this video for the YouTube algorithm because it really helps our channel and it's a small, free way you can show your support. You can also subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you want to be notified every time we post a new balloon twisting or balloon decor tutorial. So hit that like button, grab your supplies, and let's get started. Remember, if at any point I'm going too fast, you can slow down this video or pause if you need to practice an aspect of the shape. We're going to first start with this red balloon and inflate it until we have about 5 finger lengths tail. We're gonna be making a lot of twists, and a larger tail is probably better than a shorter one. To start this shape, we are going to make a 1-inch bubble and turn it into an ear twist. Remember that to do this with the nozzle, all you need to do is grab the nozzle with the same hand that you're holding the other balloon with. With your free hand, you're going to lift up this 1-inch bubble and twist around as you pinch with your other hand. Twist it around about 6 to 7 times. Sometimes this one comes undone, but the more that you twist it around, the more likely it is to stay. Next, we're going to make a 90-degree bend in the balloon for the elbow. I'm going to fold the balloon over about 2 inches after this first knot, and then I'm going to pinch the balloon and let it go. You can do this as many times as you want to get the shape that you're looking for. I'm looking for about that 90-degree shape, and I can also move it back and forth depending on where I want this. Next, I'm gonna go about 2 inches from this bend and create another twist. Now I'm gonna make a really small petal twist. This is going to be the head. So I'm going to bend the balloon over so that it's only about 1 inch or 2 inches high. Now I'm going to twist it around to create a small petal twist right here. Next, I'm going to make 6 consecutive 1-inch bubbles. These are going to be the chest and the abs of Spider-Man. So the first bubble that you make and the last balloon that you make are going to be the chest muscles, which I usually make slightly bigger than the 4 in the middle that are the ab muscles. I try to make a 1-inch bubble here for the first chest muscle, and then for the next 4, I'm gonna try to create a little bit smaller by putting a little more pressure as I'm twisting. See how that one's a little bit smaller than the first one? This takes a little bit of practice to get the different size consecutive bubbles, but keep practicing, you'll get it. It's not a big deal if you don't have the right proportions right off the bat. So I have 5 consecutive bubbles here, the first one being the chest muscle, the next 4 being the abs, and now I'm going to make the next chest muscle, which will be about the same size as this first one that I made. Now I'm going to join this twist right here with this joint right here under the head. All I need to do for this is put pressure on both sides and twist all of these consecutive bubbles. You can kind of see them coming together. All I need to do with this red now is to make the other hand, and it's time to work on the other half of Spider-Man's body. I'm going to try to make it symmetrical, so about 2 inches in, I'm going to make a bend, pinch it. Now I have that 90-degree turn. About 2 inches from that bend, I'm going to make a 1-inch bubble and turn that into a ear twist. Remember, for these ear twists slash pinch twists, all you need to do is squeeze both sides, lift up, and twist that bubble. We don't need the rest of this red balloon, so I'm going to do a quick break. We don't need the extra scrap. We can let go of this one. Let this one go until it's no longer inflated. And now I'm going to tie this one off. There we go. Next, you're going to inflate your blue balloon about the same length with 5 to 6 finger lengths tail. We're gonna start with Spider-Man's foot, so we will make a 1-inch bubble for the heel. We'll make a petal twist for his foot. I usually make a 2-inch pedal twist and twist that around. I like to hide this nozzle because I think it looks cleaner, so all you need to do for that is to hold it near this joint, lift up the bubble and twist it around, and it will become an ear twist. So now we have Spider-Man's foot, we have the first part of his leg, which is his shin. I want to make a knee right here, so I'm going to do a 1-inch bubble and turn that into a pinch twist. There we go. Now we have a thigh right here, and we're going to make a 1-inch bubble after his thigh. Turn that into a pinch twist, and this is how we're going to connect his legs to his upper body. So once you have one of Spider-Man's legs and you have this circle here that we made with the consecutive bubbles, you're going to connect this twist with this joint right here at the top of his leg. One of the easiest ways to do that is to just stick this ear twist through that circle of consecutive bubbles. Now we've connected the two Spider-Man colors together. Now what I want to do is take these two chest muscles and twist them together. So at the top of these abs right here, which are the four smaller consecutive bubbles, I'm going to squeeze it and then twist the chest muscles together 3 or 4 times. Now it should look like this. With my remaining blue balloon, I can feel the air pressure on the inside is kind of tight, so I'm gonna squeeze it. I'm going to bring this blue balloon up, and I need to make a twist here and connect it into this joint here where Spider-Man's neck is. I don't need to make a twist in this balloon, but if that's easier for you, go ahead and give that a shot. You can also just put pressure on this blue balloon towards the back of the neck and then twist Spider-Man's upper body above, like where his chest is. So now we should have something like this, where we have Spider-Man's chest, we have the back of him, and one leg. We're gonna take the blue balloon again and bring it down. Again, you can make a twist if you want to, if that's easier for you, or you can just push this blue balloon into this joint right here where the top of his leg is at and twist around this ear twist along with the leg and the remaining blue balloon. I usually like to put one arm down and one arm up. I think it just looks a little better. And we are just gonna replicate this leg using the rest of our blue balloon, but working backwards. So we'll make 2 inches for the thigh here. Make another 1-inch balloon that we're going to turn into a pinch twist for the knee. Make about 3 inches for his shin. Now we're going to make a pedal twist about the same size as the one we made over here. And we have a little bit extra here on the end. This is kind of a difficult quick break because we still need a little piece on the end here for the heel. So I'm gonna quick break it as close to the end here as possible, let out some air so that I can tie the balloon off so that it doesn't deflate. And then I'm gonna hide that nozzle into this joint here. So I just broke off the very end of that balloon, but it deflated my heel here. So what I'm gonna do is just inflate it so that I have about a 1-inch bubble and then tie it off. If you don't have enough room, and this might be easier for you, you can take what's left of this blue balloon here, hold it next to this joint, lift up the heel and twist it around Because this is not tied off, I would twist it around a lot of times, maybe like 8 to 10 times. Now you have your basic Spider-Man shape. If you have an extra white balloon, you can tie this around Spider-Man's hand and it will look like he is hanging from a web. And the very last thing we'll do is use our Sharpie to draw a spider on his chest here and also draw the spider web and his eye design on his face. And that is our finished Spider-Man design. You can even stretch his web out a little bit and let him go, and it looks like he's flying through the air. If this has been helpful for you, don't forget to like this video for the YouTube algorithm. It's a very small, free way you can show your support, and it really helps our channel. You can also subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you want to be notified every time we post a new balloon twisting or balloon decorating tutorial. Thanks so much for watching. Good luck with your balloon Spider-Man. I'm Joey. I'll see you next time.